Hey everyone, it's Blockchain Bernie here, broadcasting live from sunny California. Welcome to this latest episode. This is about the Rust programming language, but don't worry, even if you're not a programmer, this video is for you, so keep watching. If you are a programmer, this video is also for you, so keep watching as well. So the Rust programming language has gained some traction in, you know, recent years, and especially in the blockchain community. So what does a programming language for blockchain actually mean? Well, there is several things where programming languages come into play in blockchain technology. So number one would be writing clients front ends, writing web front ends for like Web3 apps or DeFi apps or something like that, right? That's not where Rust is popular these days. It might become, and in my personal opinion, it should become popular there, but as of today, it's not popular. So you see a lot of JavaScript there, you know, and JavaScript has eaten the world, and, you know, it's just ubiquitous, and it's everywhere. And because it's ubiquitous, it's so popular for anything running in a web browser. The second thing where a programming language comes into play with blockchain is writing the actual code of the blockchain validators. So what's a blockchain anyway? It means it's something that's not 100% centralized, right? So you have lots of validators that validate transactions. So blocks are being produced by someone who gets lucky and, you know, gets to produce a block at a certain point in time. But then there's others that witness that and validate that block. And, you know, there is so many validators. It could be, you know, just tens of validators in like highly centralized blockchains such as BSC. But it can be thousands of validators in highly decentralized blockchains such as Solana, which has one of the highest Nakamoto coefficients in the industry. The Nakamoto coefficient is measuring the decentralization of a blockchain. But also other blockchains have, you know, high degrees of decentralization. So that means, you know, the code that's running on a smart contract blockchain is executed by so many validators. And the software for that validator, that needs to be written somehow. And Rust is popular in that field. So that was number two. And then number three is writing the actual smart contracts. So writing the dApps, the decentralized apps that run on top of a smart contract blockchain, there you need a programming language as well. And Rust is gaining a lot of traction in that field as well. So let's talk about why Rust and what are actually the features. What's different with Rust than with other programming languages? And if you think about that validator software and the smart contract software, and you remember that blockchains are about, you know, potentially thousands of validators running the same code over and over again just to validate that, you know, the one validator that produced the block has done the right thing. So all the others need to replay that and execute the same code just in order to validate it. So if you think about that, you figure, man, performance is really important in blockchain, right? And then if you also think about blockchain's vision, right? Blockchain, public blockchains are there to make a meaningful change to society, right? And get the world away from that centralized winner-takes-all kind of mode to a more community-owned, community-controlled, own-your-own-data mode, which, you know, which the blockchain stands for. If we want to make that meaningful change to society, we have to get a lot of people and eventually billions of people get on board with the blockchain. That means the blockchain needs to scale, right? There's no point in something that can do 100 transactions per second, and then you have to silo it into layer twos with ZK proofs and stuff like that, which are great things, but they are not kind of that worldwide scaling in just one layer and you know, global price discovery and stuff like that that we want to do. So we want to scale that whole thing. And that means both the code and the validator and also the code in the smart contracts, they need to be fast. So that means, you know, having like interpreted programming languages, and even if they have just-in-time compilers and stuff, it's probably not the right choice. You want to have a programming language that's, you know, close enough to the hardware to be as fast as possible. So that's where Rust comes into play. And, you know, if you think of hardware programming close to the hardware, other languages such as C or C++, come to mind as well. Rust is kind of a modern version of these C, C++ things. And it has an additional feature that's called safety, right? So all the problems that we, you know, that there have been classically a lot of problems with C and C++ programs called memory leaks. So that means you allocate some memory, then the programmer forgets to deallocate it. And, you know, frankly, it is tough to get the code correct, that in all circumstances and in all branches that the code executes, you do the right thing and, properly deallocate what you've allocated before and stuff like that. And these memory leaks are just, you know, they are crazy stuff. Most of the time they are to blame when you need to reboot your PC or something, because some, and in modern operating systems, of course, it has been greatly reduced. But, you know, think 10, 20 years back with Windows and everything, you know, it crashed all the time just because the apps had memory leaks. And we cannot afford that in a blockchain, right? It has to, the blockchain has to be 100% reliable. We don't want it down or anything like that, right? So it has to be a safe programming language, and it has to be safe in concurrency mode as well. So if we do things in parallel, and if we want to scale, we need to do things in parallel, right? We cannot just do one thing after the other. We have to do as many things in parallel as we can in order to make that whole thing scalable. But when things run concurrently, and by the way, there's a subtle difference between concurrency and parallelism. So parallel means we have, you know, different hardware that actually runs in real parallel. And concurrency just means it seems like it's in parallel, but under the hood, it's kind of time sliced. So we only have one bottleneck of hardware that executes everything. And then the hardware time slices things into several threads, right? So, but anyway, whether it's concurrency or whether it's parallelism, you know, it is hard to write code that is safe when it comes to concurrency. And Rust helps there, right? And it is tough to write code in Rust that is not time safe, right? So that's a great advantage of Rust, which you know, many blockchain developers feel attracted to, right? You need that safe code that also runs safely in concurrent environments. You need it performant, and there is one feature that is quite unique. If you get all these three, right, performance and then safety in concurrent environments, and then number three is what is number three now? Number three is not having a garbage collection, right? So all these, there are so many other programming languages that want to avoid those memory leaks that I talked about in the beginning of this video. And in order to avoid the memory leaks, like the programming language manages the memory itself, so the programmer doesn't have to allocate the memory himself and then or herself, obviously, and deallocate it. The programming language does it for them. But then, you know, there might be variables or data in memory that becomes unusable, just, you know, has aged and it's not accessible anymore in the code anyway, so it can be deleted, right? So then these programming languages let the memory run full, and when the memory threatens to come under pressure, they stop the world, right? They stop all your program that the developer has developed, and then they run a garbage collection, trying to find pieces in memory that are not needed anymore and can be disposed of. And this stop the world, you know, it's kind of unacceptable in anything that's close to real-time environments. Not saying that blockchains are necessarily always real-time applications, but, you know, garbage collection doesn't work in real-time, right? That garbage collection also, you know, doesn't work in, you know, it's not really advantageous in blockchain environments because you want some predictability, right? Think about the block times or slot times in Solana, which is 400 milliseconds. You know, it's just, you know, 0.4 seconds. It's like boom, 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 boom. Every time, every 400 milliseconds, we have a new block. Then if the world stops in between and we do a garbage collection, and we never know in advance how long the garbage collection takes, right? It can take 40 milliseconds, but, you know, in some cases it can take 2 seconds. And that's not what we want, right? So if we want a programming language that's fast because it's close to the hardware, you know, that is, you know, it needs to be compiled, it needs to be type safe, it needs to be safe with regards to concurrency and have no garbage collection, then the air gets really, really thin. Try to figure it out, right? You can do C, C++, assembly language, which are, you know, all of them are low-level older languages that all have their advantages, but also they don't feel modern, right? And, you know, having modern C++ is you know, it has so many issues, right? And just writing everything in C is really low level, right? You don't have high level constructs or stuff like that, right? Yeah. So I think Rust is kind of the only choice, right? And there is another programming language emerging right now that's built on top of Rust. It's called Move. It's the Move language. And that's just built as kind of a subset of Rust and has some special features that make these move semantics that originated in Rust, right? Rust has the move semantics, so you move ownership of a block of memory of a variable from one place to the others just to make sure that there is no shared ownership, and then you have a concurrency conflict, right? That's going to be avoided. So that's why Rust came up with this unique move semantics. And that's, you know, taken to the extreme in that programming language called Move. It's being adopted by, you know, some blockchains, modern blockchains such as Aptos or Sui. So that's also a great language. It's also supported by Solana recently, so you can write smart contracts in Move. But I would consider that kind of the Rust family of languages, right? Yeah, so that was my little overview on why Rust is so popular in the blockchain community. Do you agree with me on anything, on everything that I said? Do you feel, you know, C, C++ is kind of cumbersome? Let me know in the comments. Do you agree Rust is kind of almost the only choice for high-performance blockchains? Let me also know in the comments. And see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Catch you later.